Have you ever wanted to use your camera as a webcam? Maybe you can live stream via USB-C or the USB port on your camera, but you kind of notice how it has that choppy look. The audio and video is a little bit out of sync, and you kind of look like already an online video that is like a live stream, but it's kind of dropping frames occasionally. Well, this is the kind of stuff that we want to get rid of. And even with great quality, it's not super distracting, but it's something that people notice, and that is exactly what we don't want in the video. Instead, don't you wish your videos looked and sounded like this, very smooth and look like it's coming directly out of the camera? Because it is coming directly out of the camera, but there are 7 things that if you're not doing, it's going to give you the way that the video was looking super choppy and ugly looking, and it can get worse versus looking like this. So let's get into it. The first thing is make sure that the lens of whatever camera that you're using, especially your dedicated camera, is clean. This may not seem like that big of an issue, but more people than you think actually record in auto. And if you're coming from vlogging, if you're coming from recording a presentation or anything where you have to leave your normal recording environment and then switch over into doing something like this, you probably may have some dust, some fingerprints, some smudges on there. And if you're running in auto, then what will happen is the camera is trying to see through all of that stuff, or even your phone. And so the shutter speed is slowing down because natively it's going to darken the image. So you want to make sure that if you do have any smudges, any fingerprints, grease, or anything like that, just from your hands, your hair, whatever, by accidentally touching the lens, you get all that gunk off. I like to use the Zeiss lens wipes. Those work best. They are slightly moistened so that I can clean, which I'm probably triggered some people that with the M word, but I won't say it again. It's so that you can clear the gunk off. Yes, microfiber towels can be great, but once they get oil in them, it just smears it all over the place. So these are disposable. They're great. I get like the 220 something box, and it lasts me many, many months, in addition to cleaning my glasses. Because if you have eye autofocus in your camera and it's trying to see the face and the eye or whatever, yeah, these cameras are smart enough to switch between, but I don't want the camera to work unnecessarily hard if it doesn't have to, by doing something that I can fix. So first thing of the rule, if you don't do nothing else, clean the lens on your camera, especially if it's your phone or your webcam. The second thing is making sure that you have proper lighting. I don't care if your camera is a low light beast like the Sony ZV-1 is, you still need light. Every camera still needs adequate lighting. And if you prefer a darker theme look, maybe you got like RGB lights behind you or whatever the case is, you're still gonna need adequate lighting. So at least make sure the subject, which should be you, is well lit. And if you are using automatic settings, and let's say you're rushing, you don't have time to really dial in the settings like you would prefer, I like to use the auto white balance lock and the exposure lock set to custom buttons on my camera. There's a video up in the information card or down in the description below when it's available, so that you can see my settings and how I do that. But that way, if I am using auto or aperture priority or shutter priority, any of those automatic kind of base settings, once I find something that looks good, I just want the camera to stop, like just stay there. So I'm telling it the same thing, especially if you have window lighting that's coming in and out, or again, you just are in a weird environment like hotel rooms usually are. And so the lighting can be visually fine to the eyes, but not necessarily for the camera. So once I find something that looks good, I like to lock it. This can help with the recording for the videos, especially because the settings aren't constantly adjusting. And if your shutter speed gets too low, then it can tend to look a little bit wonky. Next on the list is going to be your cables. Most people don't think that as long as it's in this live streaming setup, or you're only using it when you travel, and maybe it stays in your purse all the time or your bag or whatever the case is, still is going to have wear and tear on it, even if you treat your stuff really well like I do. Every 12 to 18 months, I'm going to be swapping my heavily used cables out, because the last thing that you want is for you to actually need it, don't have a replacement. And if you only have one, two is one, one is none. So make sure you get it in multiples. Most cable sets come in at least 3. I like to use the JS aux cables, especially for I'm using like my Rodecaster Pro 2, stuff like that, that's data capable and it can charge, but you need something that has the high speeds too. So I like to use my Condor Blue USB-C cable, because that is long enough that I can get some distance no matter how I want the camera set up, but it not really deteriorate the image, because the longer it has to transfer that data, the more it has the possibility of kind of breaking up. Just to simplify that explanation, the shorter the cable, the better, but you obviously need the reach, but I want that to be a strong enough cable. So if it's in your regular streaming environment, or how you have your podcast set up or whatever, every 12 to 18 months, go ahead and swap your cables out. yes, you may say that the cable looks fine, it's not fraying or, you know, breaking at the seams, and you shouldn't let it get to that point. But our biggest thing here is data transfer and the use of us putting that to work. Sometimes you can get maybe like 2 or 24 months or whatever the case is when it comes to the setups, 2 years to 24 months. But why wait? Why chance it? It's just not worth it. Cables are super cheap and it just makes sense. 2 is 1 and 1 is none. So it makes sure you get at least a set of 3. So you have one that you're using, 1 for backup and 1 if all hell breaks loose. Now this next one I'm guilty of more than anything else, and that is having a bajillion internet windows open. I literally counted 38 and then I found some rogue internet windows. Like, look, judge yourself. All right, don't worry about what I'm doing. I'm out here working in these real and digital streets. But 38 internet taps just across doing things, working progressively throughout the day, throughout the week, whatever. So if you are a chronic tab opener, just go ahead and exit out of, usually it's like Google Chrome, Safari, or Mozilla Firefox, whatever. Even if it's not a resource hog like Chrome is, go ahead and close out the browser. If you don't need the internet windows while you're recording, just go ahead and close it, because the more your computer has to process, the more that it can try to drain on the resources when you're actively recording, and you want your stuff to be in sync. Even if you're recording 20-30 minutes, if you don't need those internet browsers, go ahead and close them. Something that I like to do, especially when I had older computers, just to kind of still be able to use a web page or something, is you can do it in a read-only mode or offline mode, or you can just kind of take a screenshot of it. Now, if you have any kind of frustration or hesitation about that, save it as a bookmark. Then you won't lose anything. I'm telling you, as a chronic tab opener, I empathize with those of you that have like 12, 15, 30, 11 different internet tabs open. But just for right now, recording the videos, we want our stuff to look right and look tight. So go ahead and close those browsers. Now this next one is still in the same vein, and that's to go ahead and close any resource hog type programs. That could be something like a Final Cut Pro 10 or something else that just takes a lot of resources from the computer. No matter if your computer is fully spec'd out, it does have a cap. All computers do. It makes no sense to push it there. Or even if you just have a base model, any kind of computer, it just makes sense to close the stuff that you're not actively using while you're recording, and then you can re-engage with that stuff later. There are workarounds. Again, if you are working with an older computer and you're still trying to do this, it probably can do 1 or 2 things well, but not 3 and 4 different things. So close these extra programs that honestly are making your footage look worse than it should be. Next up is to make sure that for your computer, even if you're using an adapter, sometimes they're not all equal. So all USB-C ports are not equal. Some will be fast and for higher forms of data transfer. So it could be up to 30 and 40 gigabytes transfer, whereas some may just really be for charging, and that's about it. So it depends on the computer, it depends on the port, but I would encourage you to go ahead and Google that real quick just to see what are the best ports on your computer, or for if you're using an adapter for a USB-C adapter, just to see how that may work. Not all ports are graded equal, so make sure you check that because it will impact your footage. So I want to show you what that actually looks like when it makes a difference of using like something that's not a fast cable, especially on something like the ZV-E1. So this is the Sony ZV-E1 Tamron 20mm f2.8 lens at 2.8, but you can notice just a slight difference with the quality because I'm using 720p 30, and that's what happens if you don't have a fast enough data capable cable. You can select 4K 30 all you want to, but it's not going to look as best as it could. Now, is this miles better than most webcam quality? Yes, when you have adequate lighting, you know, adjusting your white balance, making sure that your settings are a bit dialed in. But if you're on the go, you're traveling, this may be all that you have, and this still would look good. It still would be something that would be presentable. And if you didn't tell anybody, they honestly would notice because it looks better than the average webcam built into any computer that you're usually going to be traveling with. And just for reference, this is what the webcam into my 2016 MacBook Pro looks like. And needless to say, it looks like trash in a bag. So I'm gonna switch over to 4K 30 with a data capable cable that can do that. And also making sure that you do plug it into a port. Some computers specify which ports are faster or not. So that's something to consider. So let's swap over to the 4K 30 with the USB-C in this camera, all settings being the same. We're just simply increasing the resolution and making sure that we can get that out of the camera via USB-C. And now switching over to the Elgato Cam Link in 4K 24p and using the QuickTime to record simply by plugging this into my computer now versus what I did when I plugged it into the CalDigit. The port does matter. And so if the port is not necessarily going to be fast enough, then that can make a difference. And I mean fast enough, not that it's not generally fast, but fast enough for what you're trying to do with your camera and your footage. So I'm gonna switch over to Ecamm Live and show you what that looks like. This is what the USB-C would look like with Condor Blue, plugging this directly into my computer, which would give it sometimes a better performance if the port or the device or the adapter that you're using is not fast enough for what you're trying to do. Now, this is the image coming from the Elgato Cam Link, and this is the HDMI connection, obviously still doing the 4K. And in my opinion, this looks miles better than the USB-C version. Now, no different aesthetics or color grading or anything like that has changed. It is still everything else being the same. Now, most people would say, well, I don't want to carry quote unquote all of that when it comes to the capture cards and whatnot. But honestly, I just keep all my stuff already connected. I use a smaller cable, the one that comes with the Elgato Cam Link. It's a smaller USB-C. It costs me nothing extra in time. Now, you will notice that there is still a slight delay in the quality of the audio and video sync. But I'm going to show you how to fix that in just a second, simply by switching over to Ecamm Live, because we can continue to dial that in. But even if you just did this, nobody would honestly be able to tell the difference. But since we can, let's go ahead and switch over to Ecamm Live. Now, if you notice in any of those tests that I did with my camera, I was using various different setups, but I was using something that was a software based on the computer, whether that's QuickTime or if I'm using something that is like Ecamm Live, again, a computer-based program. The reason why I do this instead of a browser-based option is because anytime I'm reliant on the internet can go out, it can go slow, whatever the case is. Even with the best of the best internet speeds connected via Ethernet, and we're doing all the best practices, when the internet goes away or goes out, so does that recording option, which is another reason why I prefer something that is on my computer. It's nice to have access to those if you want to use it, but I find that I get the best performance, no audio artifacts like any pops, clicks, or weird noises that honestly come from who knows where. I prefer to just keep control of the things that I can control. Now, if you plan to do any kind of recording, I highly encourage you to customize your camera button layout so it's easy for you to navigate, to go from vlogging, to go from your live streaming setup and do calls and meetings, to just your regular dedicated YouTube videos. Now, that video is coming up on the screen. If you want to check that out, make sure that you do so, because I highly think that you should. I highly encourage you to check it out. You know what I'm trying to say. All right, y'all, let's get over to that video, because it's a good one.